speed with the new easy-to-use controls and add slow motion or high-speed effects. Freeze the action or reverse and replay scenes in your video. All the tools you need for speed effects have been consolidated in one place. Let's get started. To enter time remapping, select the clip on your timeline, right-click and select Time Remapping, or select the Time Remapping button on the toolbar. In the Time Remapping window, you can play or scrub through the video to figure out where you want to change the speed of playback, reverse the action, or freeze a frame. Click the Mark In button, play your video, and when you want the effect to stop, select the Mark Out button. This highlights the segment of the clip that you want to work with. Click the Speed button and drag the slider to set the speed for the selected segment. Dragging to the right increases the speed. Dragging to the left slows the speed. If you want to gradually apply the speed change, you can mark the Ease In and Ease Out checkboxes. To verify the changes you've applied, review the thumbnails that appear below the playback controls. An icon in the upper left corner of the thumbnail indicates the effect that you have added. Quick like a rabbit or slow like a turtle. Let's select another segment and apply a reverse effect to it. We'll mark In and Out our segment we want to work with and click the reverse button. We could also type in the number of times we want it to reverse and replay. You can also layer effects, so after selecting reverse, we can also make it high speed. We can preview our video at any point by clicking the Playtime Remapping Results button. We can then select any segment and go back and make adjustments. To freeze a frame, select the point in time you want to freeze. And click the Freeze Frame button and set the number of seconds for the frame duration. To remove or modify any segment or freeze frame, select the clip and press the trash icon or modify the effect applied. Once you finish adding effects to your video, click OK to return to the edit workspace. Now we can preview our video.